Today we got The Plot in You, Divide, just came out. Fresh song, super excited. This is Pardon My Reaction. All right, man.
What's up?
The Plot in You, Divide, new song. Not real familiar with the band, but I know they've been in the mix for a little while, and I've heard the name multiple times. Have you heard these guys?
No.
I have not.
It's kind of been a trend. I honestly haven't heard of a lot of people we've reacted to. So yeah. That's actually probably a good thing because that is genuine.
It is genuine. Yeah. I honestly have not listened. I could not name a song these guys have played. And that is true. I feel like there was like the tier of bands that I really loved. And then there was that kind of second tier. And I'm not saying they're better or worse. I'm just saying the ones I really appreciated. And then there was kind of the bands that I didn't spend a lot of time on.
Yeah.
This is one of them. And I should know these guys. I feel like they've been around long enough that I should have listened to them at some point. Mm. But this song just came out a couple, 15, 20 hours ago this time. They're from Fearless Records. It's a good record company. So I'm excited to hear it.
Yeah.
But before we get started, guys, if you can hit that subscribe and like button, share our content. If you like what we do, we're trying to build this up. We've only been doing it for a week and a half now.
Yeah.
So we're getting music videos up there. We love the support that you guys have given us already.
Always.
It's been amazing. And go check out Pardon My American Podcast, which is our main show. We have that on a separate channel. You can look that up. And if you have any song requests, guys.
Hit us up in the comments.
Yeah, hit us up in the comments. You can also email us at pmareacts@gmail.com.
Yep.
And we can try to do those because we want to hear what you guys have to say and what you guys want us to hear. Because maybe you know something we don't. And I love finding new stuff.
You probably do.
You guaranteed you do. So hit us up. Make sure you stop right now and hit that subscribe button. Don't go any further until you do so.
Let's get into this.
Let's do it. That thing.
Whoa.
Oh, yeah. That's rocking, dude. Oh, weird video.
Almost looks like a
Jimmy Gorgon. It's almost like Fashion Week in the UK.
A little bit. The guy, the person in the black that showed up there, almost like with whatever mask they're wearing,
yeah.
Almost looked like a Demi Gorgon.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean?
Sure. It's bizarre. I mean, I really like the sound so far. It comes right in. It's very rocking, dude. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's not like overtly heavy, but it's not soft. It's definitely like it hits you. It's got a good like rhythm to it. I'm already liking
the
it.
The sound of the beginning threw me off. I was like, what is this?
Vroom, vroom. I felt like I was like going into some like weird state of mind there for a second. So far, so good, man. I'm liking the look of this so far.
Yeah, let's keep going.
Oh, yeah. Demi Gorgon. Yeah. Yeah. It's a nightmare when no one fights for. Okay. I get the same stare. Don't risk thinking. We're barely
human. We self-abuse and we're so confused. Getting a lot of Bring Me the Horizon vibes.
I am getting that vibe. So here's the problem. Sometimes when we say this stuff on the show, you got to understand that when we say like Bring Me the Horizon, that's because that's the most modern thing we've heard that sounds similar to this. That doesn't mean that these guys weren't doing it first. We don't know.
Oh, no, yeah.
Like, have they always sounded like this?
Yeah, I've never heard this before.
Are Bring Me the Horizon copying them?
Maybe.
Oh, Bring Me the Horizon. Get it together. No, either way, it has that, it drops out and it's really slow and he's just got that tone that's very Ollie from Bring Me the Horizon.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like it though. Risk thinking, we're barely human, we self-abuse and what's so confusing, just keep sleeping.
Digging the scream.
Very much.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, pause this. Okay. I love that.
That's good.
I freaking love that. I love that chorus, man. So the Bring Me the Horizon stuff, like that style. Listen, I love Bring Me the Horizon.
Oh, yeah.
I know you do too. My kids love Bring Me the Horizon, and that's why they're doing it. Let's be real. They're finding Bring Me the Horizon. I'm not trying to get on them because we're talking about plotting you, but they're trying to find that niche that like younger people is going to like it. Wives are going to like it.
Set them apart somehow.
Yes. Yeah. And you see a lot of bands doing that. Asking Alexandria, all these guys are kind of going into that like more mainstream vibe, a little bit cleaner. These guys do it well. But that chorus to me, dude, that murders, dude. Like that singing and again, dude, the harmonies, the rhythms, like the way that he actually sings it, his tone, phenomenal, dude.
Yeah.
Phenomenal. I love it. Can we go back a little bit on that chorus? Because I want to hear that again.
Go back a little bit.
Yes. So good.
So good. Oh yeah,
got some avatars here.
I also get like right at the end of that chorus too. It almost was a little bit of a Breaking Benjamin feel almost.
Yeah, there's a lot of hints of stuff because right in the middle of that chorus there, the way he does that, that kind of mm-hmm. shit, that's so Chino from Deftones.
Mm.
That is Deftones-esque as far
dude,
as
you can definitely see all his influences coming out.
Oh, hey, dude. And they're good influences. Let's be real. Yeah. If you're modeling yourself after any of these bands we just mentioned, that is awesome. He's got that breathiness to his voice. And see, there's a difference between nasal and breathy. Mm. And breathy is beautiful, man. I think if you got that like air into that into your vocals, it sounds, I don't know, it's soothing. It's soothing. I don't know how else to say it, dude. I need to go like church right now. I don't know what's up, dude.
Yeah.
All right, let's get this going. That's cool. Great guitar tone. They'll entertain you, control the ways to. Can it sustain through generations? Mm. You feel connected through self-expression. Don't ask a question. They might kill you! Oh, okay.
Yes.
That right there.
That whole part was good, dude. I loved that whole part.
The transitions are incredible. Yeah. That to me is like the number one thing with a band. If you have clean, smooth transitions, you've already accomplished the goal. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because writing a riff is like, you know, it's, I'm not saying it's easy, but I'm saying writing a riff is writing a riff, and that's great.
Yeah, but when you have to mold them all together to form the music itself.
It's musicianship.
That's what makes it hard. Anyone can pluck on a guitar.
Yep.
But putting it all together is the difficult part.
Dude, so far, absolutely digging this. And if you go back about 5 seconds, this part that's where we stopped at is that Deftones part that I'm talking about. That is very Chino. Love it, dude. You feel connected through self-expression. Don't ask a question. They might kill you. Oh.
I really like the choir and right there that they have going. Tick, tick,
they
tick,
have such incredible layering of sounds, dude. And we've referenced this on a couple other songs. It's just whoever produced this did an amazing job. Whoever recorded this did an amazing job. And so many hints of, as a nu metal kid, this makes me so happy because it does have a little bit of that nu metal vibe and some of that where it starts to pick up there, the Chino vibe that I'm talking about, and you may disagree with that, but I definitely am hearing some Chino in that.
Yeah.
So,
especially on that one part, I hear it too.
Yep. Loving it. Let's keep going, man. Good screaming. Oh. That was a weird...
Oh, kind of raw vocal almost.
Ooh. Whoa. Mm. Oh, great drumming.
The breath. What? The breath.
I'm so bummed you stopped it right there. We have to, but I'm so bummed because I... dude, what's... Okay, are we watching...
And then goes back into it, and then...
Are we watching a childbirth happen?
I have no idea.
There's a pregnant woman with some... she's got some nipple cups on, dude. You know what I'm saying? God.
They did a little different thing with the way they were doing the drums and everything. It was...
Yeah.
A lot different sounding, but it was sick.
The drummers. Like,
the drumming good. Almost had a chugging to it. It was cool.
Dude, it's just being creative with your instrument, man, and giving it a little bit more juice than the average band would do. And yeah. I got to respect that. That was a great little run right there. Did you bring it back a couple seconds?
Yeah.
I want to feel that part because I feel like it got real juicy there.
Okay, here we go. Right into that.
So
yeah, that was perfect.
Yeah, listen, I love bridges, and you always anticipate these crazy things. That was a nice bridge because you forget that little digitalized, stuff's moving around.
The sounds that were coming, almost like the guitar string screeching, it sounded like that a little bit. It was like used as a sound clip, and they were like putting it in. It sounded awesome.
Dude, I gotta be real.
I've never heard people add so much like screeching in there like that and made it work so well.
It works really well. And I love the chorus so much that this is one of the songs that I look forward to the chorus. And a lot of times you look forward to the bridge because you know it's just this is a special thing that they do. But this chorus is so good that I want to hear this chorus over and over and over again. Yeah. I actually really dig this chorus. Yeah,
the chorus is the most prominent piece in this one.
All right, man. Let's finish her up here. So
what is going on here, dude?
I don't know.
I don't know what that was.
It's called Divide. I'm curious. I'm going to go back after the show and read those lyrics because I definitely feel like there's... Because when you're watching the video and you're hearing it for the first time, like lyrics, some people focus on that. Some people are just taking in the imagery and the sounds.
Yeah.
That's what we do, obviously. But I feel like those lyrics probably have some good meaning.
Oh, yeah.
Especially with today's day and age.
It definitely pertained to today.
Modern time, yeah. So I'm going to check that out. I will say the top comment that they have on here said, I said this over 10, this is, I don't know who this is from. I said this over 10 years ago and it still remains relevant. Landon is one of the greatest vocalists of our generation, period. These guys have been my favorite since I was first born. Jesus, how long have they been around? Found this band on vinyl for $180 last year. So they're obviously, they have a very good following. They've been around for a long time. And you know what? I'm not going to disagree, man. That guy has very good. I'm guessing, I don't know. I don't know if the screamer also is the singer, if the guitarist is a singer. However it is, if he's the only one doing it or there's a backup that's doing the singing, whatever you're doing,
brilliant.
Keep doing it because it sounds spectacular. Loved it. That was Plotting You, Divide. Guys, make sure you go check and hit that little, wherever it is. Here. I don't know where it is. The link for our podcast.
The like, the subscribe button.
Yeah.
There's in the bio about us, there's a Part of My American Podcast link. Go check that out.
Yeah. Good stuff.
Awesome. Loved it.
Yeah. What do you give it real quick?
Ooh.
That's a 9 for me. That's a 9. I'm going to listen to that album as soon as I get one. Love it.
Good job, guys.
Plotting You, Divide.